Hey everyone, power over Ethernet is an awesome technology. It allows us to run a single cable, Ethernet, to a device and it'll magically receive internet and power without having to plug it into a wall outlet. That's because Ethernet cables contain 8 individual wires and some of them can be used for internet data and some for power. Although in some cases you can use the same wires for both. Either way though, if this has electricity surging through it, what happens if I plug it into a normal device that does not support power over Ethernet? Well, in the majority of cases, nothing bad will happen. I hope. Let's take a look. This is a PoE switch, which I then connect to two non-PoE devices, my HP printer and a TP-Link Gigabit switch. Because I'm a mad lad, I then plug it in another PoE switch before connecting this to a DVD player, which also does not support power over Ethernet. I haven't actually pre-tested this, but in theory, it will work. I hope so anyway, because my wife says that she needs to use the printer in half an hour to print loads of documents. Oh gosh, here we go. Let's turn this all on. Just kidding. It's actually all fine. The DVD player still boots up and is listed in my Eero app on my phone, meaning this connecting just fine to the network, despite, you know, being connected to a power over Ethernet network switch and not supporting power over Ethernet. The HP printer is also working fine and it's actually printing a document right now. So that proves that you can plug normal devices into a powered Ethernet switch without any problems. But why is this? And are there any dangers? Well, yes. It all boils down to how the power over Ethernet is implemented by the actual switch itself. A proper PoE switch will first negotiate with the plugged in device to agree on whether to just send internet data or power as well. This occurs as part of the initial handshake process where the device is registered onto the network. If a device does not support power over Ethernet, then the switch will just send standard internet traffic from that particular port without any power. But if the device does support powered Ethernet, then both internet and power will be sent down that particular cable. This is all known as active PoE because the power is actively agreed between the switch and the device. There is another type of switch though, passive PoE switches, not this one in other words. These are less common, but you can still buy them easily enough on Amazon and other shops. So it's easy to make this particular mistake. Passive PoE will always send power and data. As you can imagine, plugging a non-PoE device into a passive switch will cause loads of problems because unexpected voltage will be sent down the Ethernet cable and into the device. In the worst case, this will cause a burnout either of the device or the device's Ethernet port. So why does passive PoE exist? Well, they're often cheaper to produce, meaning that they're then cheaper for us consumers to buy. If you know that all your devices will need powered Ethernet, it could make sense to just buy a passive switch and then save some money. Plus, if you find down the line that you'd then like to plug in a non-PoE device, you're not completely stuck. While upgrading to an active switch might be your best option in an ideal world, you could explore PoE splitters instead. These are kind of like the opposite of PoE switches and injectors. You plug a powered Ethernet cable into the PoE splitter, and to be ultra technical, it sucks all the power out of the cable. Sorry, I don't know why I've done that. You're then left with a DC output and a standard Ethernet port, meaning that you can then safely use the Ethernet port and cable on your non-PoE devices. That's one option. Anyway, I think I'll just carry on buying active PoE Ethernet switches, because I know that they'll safely negotiate whether to send power or not. But what about you? Have you ever used passive power over Ethernet? Or maybe you just avoid PoE altogether? Well, I'd love to know your thoughts down in the comments. And that just about wraps up today's video. I hope you found it useful. If you did, please click the thumbs up button. Please also subscribe to my channel if you haven't already, and thanks for watching.